15 awesome Photoshop tips in under 2 minutes. Let's go. Do you find yourself running out of history states while working on a huge project? Hold down Command on a Mac, Control on a PC, and press the letter K on your keyboard to enter your preferences. Click on Performance on the left, and then increase your history on the right. Speaking of large projects, if you find your palettes to be getting in the way, simply press the Tab key on your keyboard to hide them all. Now, if you want Photoshop to fill your whole screen, press the F key twice to enter full screen mode. And are you tired of that ugly gray background surrounding your projects? Right-click anywhere on the gray and choose between gray, black, or a custom color of your choice. Now, if you're in full screen mode and need to change the size of your brush, either right-click anywhere on your project or use the square bracket keys to increase or decrease the size of that brush. Your keyboard can also be used to change the opacity of your brushes or layers. If you want the opacity decreased to 50%, press the number 5. 20%, press 2. 100%, press 0. When creating objects or selections, if you want to constrain the proportions, simply hold down your Shift key while dragging. If you need to move that object around on your canvas, the Shift key is your best friend. Holding it down while dragging the object will keep it in its vertical or horizontal path. Holding it down while using the arrow keys will allow you to move that object in increments of 10 pixels. The Shift key is also used for constraining brush strokes. If you need to create a perfectly straight line, keep your Shift key held down while brushing. If you're working on a high-resolution monitor, it may be difficult to see all the layer thumbnails. Clicking on the arrow to the right at the top of the layers palette, going down to Panel Options, will allow you to increase the size of those thumbnails. When creating new folders or layers, if you want the option to name them right from the start, hold down your Option key on a Mac, Alt key on a PC, and press the desired button. Now, when creating groups, if you wish to automatically have all selected layers included in that group, hold down your Shift key while clicking on the new group icon. If you're working with layer masks and want a more detailed view of that mask, hold down your Alt key or Option key and click on the mask thumbnail. And finally, if you want to change any of the default shortcuts in Photoshop, head to Edit and then down to Keyboard Shortcuts. I hope these tips have been helpful, and let me know if you want more in the comments below. Take care!